Okay, everybody, we got a request to do a video for multiple choice fall 21 test one. Your first two questions will be the same. The only difference will be this molecule will have a different name and you start all over. So, question two, same name. Yours will be the same name as question one. All right. Enough said. We're supposed to draw tetraethoxyundecanedione. It sounds complicated, but it's not that bad. You draw 11 carbons. That's undecane. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. Put ketones on 3 and 9. And knowing myself, there's always elements of symmetry in this question. I'm just giving you tips that I don't have to. There'll be symmetry. What are we doing? Tetraethoxy. Got to remember, ethoxy is an ethyl, but there's an O attached first. So one's got one. Six has got one. My guess is six is there. 2, 4, 6, yeah. Symmetry. Six. There's two of them on six. Still got the old symmetry going, doesn't it? Hey, that's an acetal over there. Look at that. You don't need that for this question. Over here, it's just a good old garden variety ether, right? And we also have one on 11, which is the end, right? Symmetry. So that's going to show up in question two. If you don't see the symmetry, you're not going to get question two right. Question one, though, just put some patterns down. You guys have been doing this for a while. I hope we're at the point where you got two neighbors, you say it's a triplet. You got three neighbors, you say it's a quartet. You got two neighbors, you say triplet, 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 triplet. We're almost done. Quartet. Triplet. After you got halfway there, you're done. Molecule symmetrical. Okay. So triplets and quartets. That's an easy question, isn't it? It says shade all the letters that apply. And there's no partial credit here at all. It's either you get both of them or you don't get anything. All right. So triplets, C. And quartets, D. Answer. Shade in C and D on your scantron. How many signals appear in the proton decoupled C13 NMR spectrum of? That's just a fancy way of asking how many types of carbon are in this molecule. All right. These two carbons here and here are identical. There's no differentiating them. So I'm just going to count everything to the left of my... my thing here, don't forget, I went with my yellow thing right through a carbon that's unique. It's the only unique carbon in the molecule, isn't it? The one I just went right through, don't forget to count it. I'm doing circles, and I'm only going to do circles on the left side. There's one type of carbon. Now, this is unique here. Please don't try to tell me that CH2, don't try to tell me it's equivalent to this CH2 here. It's not. They're ethoxies on a different carbon, which makes them different. So unique, every blue circle counts towards my answer. Okay. Make sure you count your blue circles carefully. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Is that one of the answers? Good. All right. So questions 3 and 4 are coming up now. How many signals will, what will the patterns in the NMR spectrum of this be and how many signals? So it's a combination of our first two questions. Again, isn't it? So we better draw this molecule. It's a benzene with two groups. It's a benzene. It's got ethyl groups on carbons 1 and 2. There's ethyl. There's ethyl, but the ethyl groups have chloros on them. One of them's on 1. Remember, the carbon attached to the ring is number 1 of the ethyl. And the next carbon is 2. And same group over here. Yep, you guessed it. He's got symmetry going on again, too. Yeah, so you want to do the signals? Yeah, the patterns? I'm going to do them. You ready? Doublet. There's one neighbor. Doublet. One neighbor. Doublet. Triplet. Triplet. Doublet. I'll go all the way around, even though there's some symmetry. Doublets and triplets. Got rid of a lot of answers, didn't we? We got to narrow down to A, B, A, C, A, D. And that's it. Beautiful. Got to do the number of signals. We'll do it in circles again. Remember, symmetrical molecule. But it's a smaller molecule. Maybe I can do the circles and count both parts. Those are identical. Those are identical. A little tricky over here, but those are identical. And these are identical. And these are identical. How many blue circles? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Doublets, triplets, 5 signals. Choice A, B. These aren't terrible questions, are they? No. And you know they're coming. And which of the following would be appropriate for use as a polar product? Ladies and gentlemen, I hope I don't have to tell you, you need to review the 3 types of solvents, because most likely he's going to pick one of the other types for this question. And you better review them. And you need to review this one fact. If there's a single hydrogen in your solvent, you can't use it for NMR. Because that's the only signal you would see. One signal for the whole spectrum, and has nothing to do with the molecule you're testing. You'd have one big solvent peak, because solvent is there compared to your thing being tested in a very large excess, right? So when I say, all of these don't have hydrogen. You know how I know? Because chloroform, and if chloroform is unique to you, you need to read the book. It's the most common solvent used in NMR. And deuterochloroform is this one. Plus, chloroform shows up in chapter 16 again, and 15. Yeah, that's not a hydrogen. I know it. Chemically, you know it does reactions like hydrogen. This is a very good question. Chemically, it does reactions like hydrogen, but in NMR, it's invisible in the hydrogen region of testing. So it doesn't show up. It's not there. So you need something that's invisible in the proton region of from 0 ppms to 12 ppms. That's our proton NMR numbers from our data table. You need something that doesn't show up there in your solvent. Carbon tetrachloride doesn't have any hydrogens, right? So these are nonpolar, both of these. I'm not picking them for this question. Nonpolar. They're good for NMR, but they're not good for this question. Per-deuteromethanol. This per-deutero, if you forgot or maybe you didn't know. Per just means every hydrogen's been replaced with. Okay? Now, what is the with? Well, in this case, it says the with is deutero. Okay? So draw methanol, but every time you want to put an H, put a D. We have a winner. We're very happy about that because a polar protic solvent is alcohols or amines, okay? Not any amine, primary or secondary. They have to have H's on the end. Okay, so far that's the only one. Hexafluorobenzene. Do I have to draw that one? Sure, why not? There's only 6 spots for fluorine. So in terms of NMR, it's a great solvent. But it's non-polar for sure. So we're not picking it for this question. And per-deutero-dimethyl-formamide, in case you're curious, formamide is this. No H because it's per-deutero. N-C-D-3-C-D-3. And that is polar aprotic. It's DMF, people. It's per-deutero-DMF. So we like choice C and E. There you go. That was a good little video for NMR, and I hope you found it useful. And we'll be back.